heard you broke up with who you broke up with me for.
That's cool.
Yeah. I won't bring it up. I swear I'm over keeping score. I don't even care how it ended. Doesn't really matter anyway. Send her in an open invitation. Even if you threw your key away.
It was just a sort of this like serendipitous moment where Shane and I were listening back to Lonely Side of Town, and it just has such a vibe and such an old school kind of groove. And I was looking at Shane and I said, man, it would be so cool to have somebody like Gladys Knight on this album. And he was like, she lives in Asheville, she's here. We talked to the people at the studio, and of course they knew her, and the rest just kind of fell into place. We just asked her if she would be into singing with us, and she immediately said yes. It was amazing.
Hey! How y'all doing?
Hey, yeah, it's nice to meet you.
I love you guys.
Yay. Well, thank you.
And I'm so proud of you guys.
Oh, wow.
I have loved country music all my life.
Just so excited.
Yeah. Oh, it's so my pleasure.
Thank
I
you.
Feel so honored. You know, I've been watching you go.
Yeah.
To me, it's one of those songs that we loved writing it, and then when we recorded it, all the parts are nailed. You know, I think everyone kind of is at their highest level on that song, which, you know, sometimes happens and sometimes doesn't. I think it just has that Motown sort of vibe to it. It's just a perfect combination of that classic sound that we have, but just taken into the, you know, modern world.
I heard you broke up with who you broke up with me for. I won't bring it up, I swear I'm over keeping score.
I don't really care how it ended. It doesn't really matter anyway. Consider it an open invitation. Even if you threw your key away. If you're ever on the lonely side of town. A little messed up Saturday night. Nothing going on and you feel like getting up to something, boy, you know I'm always down.
For a good time, little small talk, you don't need no reason at all. To call an old familiar more than a friend. You can find me right where I've always been.
No, I just love what you've done. It's so pure. And it's so just right at that person. And it's millions of people out there that feel like feeling like that, you know. And especially those who are kind of a little shy and don't want to get back into it and know you had a good thing. That kind of thing, you know. So that's what I love about this song.
You know, talking to Gladys about it, she said over and over that if you really listen to her songs, all of her biggest hits, they are actually country songs at heart. And when you really listen to, like, you know, Midnight Train to Georgia and things like that, they're country songs. And I think she just identified with our story, and she kept telling me, like, man, how did you write this in such a relatable way? So I think she's just a song person, and we knew that about her. You can tell how much she cares about, you know, what she is singing. And that's what we ultimately do when we're writing. We care about every single word. It's a highlight of our career to work with someone like her. It's something that we'll always look back on. We'll look at the pictures, we'll look at the video, and we'll listen to it thinking, wow, a true legend, you know, honored us with this performance.
Just yet another example of a moment when you just can kind of step back and realize how far we've come on our journey, that's even a possibility.
That's a good way to put it, a lonely side of town. I like that a lot. It's real.
Mm-hmm. You're recording.
Yep. So here we are. We're about to go and meet Gladys Knight. We're out in the parking lot.
Yeah. This is us before we meet Gladys Knight. And This is what we look like. This is the moment before we will be forever changed.
Yep. You will, after this. We will never look, feel, or be the same. And you'll need to see what we used to be. So there you go. See you soon.